Today we will be discussing the integumentary system, which is probably one of the least well-known organ systems in the body, even though it is very important and it actually makes up about 1/6 of our total body weight. The integumentary system is divided into two major parts, the cutaneous membrane and the accessory organ structures. The cutaneous membrane can further be divided into different regions, including the epidermis and the dermis. There is also the hypodermis, which consists of connective tissue and fat tissue, which separates the integumentary system from other organs, but it's not technically considered part of the integument. The epidermis can be further divided into 5 different layers. These include the stratum corneum, the stratum lucidum, the stratum granulosum, stratum spinosum, and stratum basale. Remembering the different layers of the epidermis might be tricky, so what I like to employ is a mnemonic. This helps remember the different layers pretty well. So what I like to do is write can Leafs get Stanley back. If you're a hockey fan and you like the Leafs, this will help you. Now remember, you don't always have to use these mnemonics or mnemonics you see in textbooks. You can always make your own up. And it's actually encouraged because it will help you remember them better. So these are the different layers, or the stratum, corneum, lucidum, granulosum, spinosum, and finally, basale. So that's just one way to remember the 5 different layers of the epidermis. Now on to the dermis. The dermis consists of 2 layers, the papillary and the reticular layer. The reticular layer is thicker and denser than the papillary layer, and it is here where you find many, but not all, of the accessory structures of the integument. These include hair shafts, pores, tactile receptors, sebaceous glands, erector pili muscle, sweat glands and ducts, hair follicles, and nerve fibers. As you can already see, there are many different structures within the integumentary system. These give rise to its numerous and various functions, including 1. To protect underlying organs from impact, abrasions, fluid loss, as well as exposure to chemicals and foreign pathogens. 2. Maintaining normal body temperature. 3. The excretion of salts and water. 4. The production of melatonin, which gives our skin its pigment. 5. The production of keratin. 6. Storage of fuel reserves in the form of lipids. 7. Sensation of touch, pressure, pain, and temperature, and the subsequent transmission of these signals to the nervous system. And 8. The synthesis of vitamin D3, which is the main topic of this video. Vitamin D3 is essential for the maintenance and the development of strong and healthy bones. It is used to produce a hormone called calcitriol, which helps increase the absorption of calcium and phosphate in the digestive tract. So how does the integumentary system fit into this? Well, it's the integumentary system, and more specifically, the epidermis, that creates vitamin D3. Take a look at the diagram on the board. Ultraviolet rays from the sun hit our skin and actually cause certain layers in the epidermis to create cholecalciferol. The layers that do this are stratum spinosum and the stratum basale. What happens is there's a steroid molecule that lies in the stratum spinosum. Once UV rays hit the skin, this converts that to cholecalciferol. Cholecalciferol then enters the blood. It circulates to the liver, where it is then converted to a molecule called calcidiol. That calcidiol then re-enters the bloodstream. And you can see that it travels to the kidney. It is calcitriol that's the main hormone that's responsible for the increased absorption of calcium, as well as phosphate, from the digestive tract. If we do not have enough calcitriol production in the body, This can lead to impaired bone growth and maintenance. In children, rickets can develop when there is a lack of calcitriol. In adults, osteomalacia occurs. This is the softening of bones. These disorders have been prevented, however, in more recent years, as foods and beverages such as milk have become fortified with vitamin D3. Nonetheless, the integumentary system still plays a large role in maintaining normal calcium levels within the blood, and therefore maintaining strong and healthy bones.